Hello guys and welcome to my channel. Today I have a fabulous meal for you, a pancetta. It will be very crispy and very nice. The rich, wonderful, meaty flavors of the pancetta combined with the taste of the caramelized vegetables, allspice berries and wine, and you can prepare in any occasion. So let's begin. I have a very nice piece of pancetta here. Can you see that? Lovely, tasty and very, very rich. I need salt and pepper and salt. Perfect. Now, I have a non-stick pan on the heat and make sure that this pan is huge enough to take all the pancetta inside. So it's huge, on the heat, and it's time for extra virgin Greek olive oil on the meat. We don't need a lot, just 2 tablespoons should be enough. And now it's time to make our pancetta sexy. Take a knife and score in a crisscross manner the pancetta, like this. And this side also. And again on the other side, the same thing. Score the pancetta. And again, carry on with massage. We need all this salt and pepper and olive oil to go inside the meat, because it's very important to marinate the meat from the inside. Perfect. And I think my pan is hot enough to put this lovely pancetta on, like this. Oh. And this is the perfect noise of a pan. This is an harmony. Now, 2 leeks, cut them into big chunks, like this. 2 carrots, skin on, the same thing. And 2 onions. 1 clove of garlic. And lot of herbs. We need some rosemary. We need some thyme. And we keep all these lovely herbs and veggies here. Now, I need a tong. And let's flip over our meat. Ah, look at this beauty. It's amazing. Give a little bit more color here. Bravo, bravo. And the meat is ready. Goes into the pan. Now, in our pan, we will add a bit of olive oil. Just 1 tablespoon should be enough. And we'll add all the veggies. Carrot. Leeks, onions, herbs, and of course the garlic. And now we want these veggies to caramelize with our spices. All spice goes in. Peppercorns goes in. Cinnamon stick goes in. And of course star anise goes in. Now, I need you to be a little bit patient and cook all these veggies for about 5 to 10 minutes until they caramelize so nice and so sexy to add them into the pan. Perfect. Now, it's time to deglaze our pan with white wine, 2 chicken cubes, the half of the water, and 1 tablespoon of mustard. Mix everything together, like this, so, so, so nice. Now, when it starts boiling, like this, come here and arrange all these lovely veggies and the stock next to the meat. Spread them at the side, like this. Now add the rest of the water. At this point, your pancetta, your pork belly should be submerged inside the stock, but the surface should be out of the stock, like this. Now it's time to cook the pancetta. Oh, amazing. Put inside the oven to 180 degrees Celsius, set to fan, for 2 to 2.5 hours. At that point, after 2.5 hours, The stock will be ready and very thick and very rich and very tasty. The pancetta will be so juicy on the inside and so crispy on the top side. So we want that, and after 2.5 hours, the best pancetta will be ready. After 2.5 hours, my pancetta smells so nice. It's so delicious, and I know before I even open the door of the oven. Now, I have prepared some potatoes to serve my pancetta. I will chop some spring onion for the freshness of the potatoes. A little bit of spring onion on the top. Like this, a little bit of herbs, some basil, some oregano. Here, make a nice bed for the pancetta so it will sit on the top. And now it's time to take the bad boy outside of the oven. Sexy. Now, so at this point, take the meat out of the pan. I know that it is so hard because actually it is melting. You see that? Oh my God. It is so crispy on the top and so tasty and so juicy on the inside. Look at that. It's just falling apart. It is so tasty. But we have to prepare the sauce, and it's so easy to do that. Just take a pan, put all these lovely juices on the pan. Only the juices, because all the juices have condensed all this flavor from the pancetta and the veggies. And take like a teaspoon of cornstarch with some cold water, mix together. I will turn on the heat. Mix together the cornstarch with the water, like this. Put it in and let the sauce get thickened. Now, take all these spices out of the meat and slice the meat into big chunks. So delicious. Look at this. Nice meat, very tasty, with no fats, because all the fat actually melted during the process of cooking. And look at this, the perfect platter. Now, we need the sauce, and the cornstarch will make the sauce very thick, the way it should be. In just a simple boil, the sauce is ready. Go on top of the meat and make a nice bath, the pancetta, with this lovely sauce. Let the sauce go everywhere. And for the end, just a little bit of herbs and just a little bit of love should be enough to have the perfect pancetta. Look at this. The fresh oregano on the top, giving a boost to the whole recipe. And I want to show you how easy it is to treat yourself with just a pan. Take a little bit of the meat, a little bit of the lovely sauce, and taste. Oh my God. This is the best way you have to treat your pancetta. Your pancetta is so tasty, actually melting into your mouth, and all these flavors from the veggies and the herbs are inside, and it is so crispy on the outside that everybody should make this recipe. Please, when you make this recipe, send me some pictures, because I will be very happy to see that. Please make comments underneath the video, share this lovely recipe with your friends, and please, please, please subscribe to our channel. See you next time. Bye bye. Yes, sir.